Welcome to the second part of our sound-focused tutorials. This time around, we'll learn to use sound emitters, which are single sound sources. Remember that any sound set using sound emitters will play as mono sounds in 3D. To show their function, we'll add a few sounds coming from behind closed doors. To do that, we'll select a sound emitter object from the assets window and place it on a map. The sound will come exactly from the spot the sound emitter is placed in, so it's important to position it carefully. The sound we want to use in this example is a child crying. In the attributes window, in S sound name, we have a list of all the available sounds. Let's find screamer crying. Now we'll modify some basic parameters from our sound emitter. In the sound range field, we'll set the range at which you'll hear the sound. We can use the presets, but this time we'll choose none to set it manually. The min-max distance fields will be used for this. The min range defines when the sound will start fading, until it fades completely at max range. The ranges are visualized by spheres for ease of use. We want the sound to be audible from a large distance, so it draws players' attention. Let's set the min to 1 and the max to 8. Another important field is type occlusion. We use it to set if we want our sound to be diminished by obstructive objects between the emitter and the player. We want our emitter to only work with distance, not objects, so we choose distance. Finally, we magnify the volume of our sound by inputting 1.5 in the F volume field. Note that if you set the F volume too high, you'll break the threshold and will cause the sound to entirely take over all other sounds on the map, so don't overdo it. To check what our emitter sounds like, you can play it by selecting the test flag in the editor. So we've managed to place a single sound, but to further add to the atmosphere, we'll add another emitter with random zombie screams from behind the door. First, copy our initial sound emitter. This time, we change this class in the attributes window from sound emitter simple to sound emitter random. This will allow us to randomly play sounds from a predefined pool. Let's modify the parameters. Most of them are exactly the same across both types of emitters. This time, we want the sound to be audible in a smaller radius and diminished by both distance and obstructions. Let's set the min distance to 1, max distance to 4, and the occlusion type to full. In the A sounds field, we select the pool of sounds for this emitter. Let's select zombie behind door and select fitting sounds while holding down the control button on our keyboard. Sounds will be played in a random order, with random intervals limited by the min and max time between sounds setting, with the values set in seconds. Let's input min 4 and max 7 seconds. We don't want the screams to drown out the sound of the child's crying, so in the F volume we'll input 0.8. Now, let's check out how it sounds in-game. Both sound emitters work now, so we're ready to go on to the next part of our tutorial.